A very good day to you all. Buka here with another video. And in this class, we are going to be talking about the projects, the proposed projects, or project example that I intend to teach you guys, used to teach you guys Node API. Alright, so starting out, you know, when I was starting out, I would usually go to YouTube for tutorials, and I would come across videos, and they would just be basic, basic things that you won't really use as Node.js developers in the real sense or in the real world. So this tutorial is going to be an all-encompassing, or this project, sorry, is going to be an all-encompassing tutorial. So it's going to teach you real-life applications that we usually do as Node.js developers in the real world. So sit back, relax, and let's get started. So here in this notes that I have here with me is a very, very long description of what to do in this project. So let's go, let's read this. So we're building a server for an online tutoring app. You have to build an online tutoring app that has three categories of users: admin, tutors, and students. A user can register a student on this platform. Afterwards, they can view all categories they belong to. They can also view all students' thoughts in a category. Other actions they can carry out are outlined further down this page. So you have actions that they can all do here. A user can also register as a tutor. Afterwards, they can perform actions specific to tutors as outlined below. So we have actions for tutors here. The last category of users is the admin. No one can sign up as an admin. Only tutors can become admins. Making a tutor an admin is up to you as to how you want to implement that. You are, however, expected to provide admin login details on your README. And it goes on and on and on, talking about functionalities and then what to do next. So I'm not going to go through all this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to drop the link to this Notion notes in the description below, so you can go through this and then understand what this project is going to be, what we are going to be building for this project. Okay, so down here I have what would be needed for this class. So the dependency packages would need Express. So prior to this class, we've had introductory classes to Express.js. Before Express.js, we've had introductory classes to the HTTP module, Node module. So in my previous classes, I mentioned that you could build out an app, a full app with the HTTP module, but in the real life sense, we normally go for Express, because Express is a framework that has been set up to make building out APIs in Node.js far more easy. So next we have is the Mongo database. So we'll be using Mongo database for this app. Whatever database you choose to use is fine. You can use Postgres, SQLite, MySQL, but for this project, I'll be teaching you with Mongo database, MongoDB. Okay, so we would also be using a package known as Express Validator. We usually I or Node.js developers usually use this Express Validator to validate our requests. So the request that is going to be sent from the client to the API or to the server is going to be validated through this Express. Some others might li like to write out their own custom functions for validation, but I usually don't stress myself to do that because sometimes you can make mistakes with that. Or why do that when you can when you have already made trusted packages for you that can help you with your validation? So the next on my list is JSON Web Token. We'll be using JSON Web Token for authentication. And then last on my list is Mongoose. So Mongoose is known as an ORM used to connect to your Mongoose MongoDB. So we use Mongoose to connect to the Mongo database. So yeah, we have it here. It's a object data modeling library for MongoDB in Node.js. So what Mongoose does in your previous class or in your previous database class, you used a package known as MongoDB clients. So MongoDB client is fine, but to me it's a bit complicated. Well, not to others, but personally to me, it's a bit complicated because setting up schemas with MongoDB client is a bit complicated for me. So what I usually do is I use Mongoose. Setting up MongoDB schemas with Mongoose is far much more easier. So you have your schema files in form of objects which you export to whatever controller you want to use it in. So that's for Mongoose. Another package we'll be using is bcrypt. I don't have that here. bcrypt.js. So bcrypt.js is also a package we'll be using for authorization in this app. So for dev dependencies, we are going to be using NodeMon. So prior to this class, a lot of you were using NodeMon for really, really simple tasks. And I explained that using NodeMon is like using a sledgehammer for a very little nail. But for this project, because we would always be restarting the server and we would not always want to be doing Control C and then starting the server up again. NodeMon helps us with that. So if you set up your NodeMon properly, when you do a Control S or when you save your file, NodeMon automatically restarts the server. Last on the list is the application we'll be using to testing out our routes, which is Postman. So you've had a previous intro to Postman. In this project or in this course with me, we'll be using Postman properly or in-depthly to document and test out our routes. So usually when you have a task like this, or if you go for a Node.js interview and you are giving tasks like this, it's better for you not to jump into the task immediately. But instead you should break down this task into little bits, which is what I've done here. So I broke down the tasks or the task into bits, or into understandable bits. So I would be using this breakdown to set up my routes. So here you have, you can see I wrote down my routes and then the verbs which these routes are going to be doing. So these are API verbs, posts. So for the users here, we have three users. We have the admin, in bracket super, so I call them super admin. So admin is like your the boss of the app. So he's going to be assigning different roles to different users. He's going to be the ultimate user of this application. So when you are building out apps, it's ideal for you to make out routes for your admin or super admin. It's very, very important. So number two is a tutor user, and then lastly we have the students. So from the previous or from the node class, I was able to break down this task. So we have the general user rules over here. I listed the general user rules and the APIs or the routes that will be controlling each functionalities. So beside the routes are the verbs. So this is going to be a post route. This is also going to be a post route. This is going to be a post route. Here we have a get route. Over here we have a delete route. And here we have a put route. So this is what we're going to be doing, We're going to be setting this up with our code. And then over here, we have the models, the different models which we're going to use to model the database. So here I have my category model and the properties which are going to be in the category model. I got all these from breaking down the task. So if you are doing this on your own and you are following me, it's ideal that you break down this task, try to understand what's going on, and then build your model. Alright, so like I was saying, we have the model, we have the category model, we have the subject model, we have the lesson model, the properties, and then we have the user model and properties. As we go, the models might not be complete, but as we go, we're going to update this. Sometimes as you build, you get to know what to do next. So we're going to be updating this if it's not complete. But yeah, that will be it for this introduction class. Next, we're going to be setting up our server. So see you in the next class.